Experiment 5, Part 4, Investigating Resonance Formulas with Quantum Theory. Recall we are using thioformate ion as an example. Earlier, we drew one Lewis formula, which required forming a carbon-oxygen double bond so that carbon, oxygen, and sulfur all had octets. However, if we use one lone pair from sulfur instead of oxygen, we draw another formula, one that still has all octets, but now contains a carbon-sulfur double bond, and oxygen has the minus one formal charge. When you end up with two or more Lewis formulas that both satisfy the octet rule, but have double bonds and lone pairs on different atoms, the ion or molecule is a resonance hybrid. That is, the actual structure is a unique thing somewhere between the two formulas. This situation arises because these kinds of ions or molecules contain a three-center bond that extends across the double-bonded atoms. And this cannot be shown in one Lewis formula because only two-center bonds are shown in these formulas. Anyway, let's directly investigate and hopefully dispel the notion that these formulas represent two different things. If so, then they will have different geometries and energies when optimized with the PM7 quantum theory. On the other hand, if we end up with identical geometries and energies, that will prove that there really is only one unique in-between structure. We already optimized one form, so let's check it out briefly. Trigonal planar, sulfur carbon oxygen bond angle of 127.121 degrees, heat of formation minus 70.48 kcals per mole. Also, we can see how the minus one charge is distributed around this ion by viewing the partial charges table. Clicking the icon gives a graphical display where the red spheres are negative and blue spheres are positive. And what this says is that the negative charge is actually shared between oxygen and sulfur. Okay, now we will build and optimize the other resonance form. Checking the completed job, we find a planar geometry with a sulfur carbon oxygen bond angle of 127.122, essentially identical to 127.121 degrees, heat of formation minus 70.48 something kcals per mole. And looking at the partial charges, we see they are indeed shared between sulfur and oxygen with the same values that were on the other formulas. Thus, quantum theory tells us that this resonance stabilized ion has a single structure about midway between the two extremes. The two optimized structures have the same geometry and charge distribution and essentially identical energies. In the next section, we will take a look at the three-center bond that is affecting how Lewis formulas are drawn for this ion.